We now move on to our opening speech, where we will have the opportunity to learn about the banking industry's perspective on strategic measures for enhancing digital supply chain finance and SME growth. Please join me in welcoming Mr. Zafar Masood, Chairman of the Pakistan Bankers Association and President and CEO of the Bank of Punjab.
रहमत हसनी साहब का आपने नाम लिया था, नज़र नहीं आ रहे, उनका स्टाफ भी नीचे था सर, नज़र ही नहीं आ रहे ना आप, ये नेशनल बैंक नज़र ना आए तो बड़ा प्रॉब्लम हो जाता है सर। लेडीज जेंटलमैन, वी गो बैक अ लॉन्ग वे, सो सारे दोस्त ही यहाँ बैठे हुए हैं, मैं थोड़ा सा फ्रेंकली बात करूँगा उसमें। मसला ये है कि जो इन्होंने आज कॉन्फ्रेंस का डायलैक्ट रखा हुआ वो अंग्रेज़ी है, थोड़ा उर्दू में खुल के बात हो जाती है, बट इसीलिए मैंने शुरू में ज़रा रहमत साहब का पूछ लिया, क्योंकि वो नीचे काफ़ी रश था, नेशनल बैंक के काफ़ी लोग खड़े हुए थे इनके प्रोटोकॉल के, तो ये मुझे अंदाज़ा था कि ये आ गए हैं या आने वाले होंगे। जब उसे नाम लिया तो मैंने कहा मुझे नज़र नहीं आया, खैरियत तो मैं पूछ लूँ। डिप्टी गवर्नर सलीमुल्ला साहब, हमज़ा, मोनस, मुनीर साहब, रहमत हसनी साहब, बेग साहब, शाह साहब, माय फ्रेंड फर्रुख, हु इज़ बिकमिंग इन दिस कॉन्फ्रेंस के कॉन्टेक्स्ट में इवन मोर इम्पॉर्टेंट विद हिज न्यू रोल। सो वी टॉक्ड अबाउट सम पॉसिबल कोलैबोरेशन फ्रॉम पीबीए प्लेटफॉर्म एंड हाउ वी कैन टेक इट फॉरवर्ड। आमिर, हुमायूं, आई कैन सी फराज, नजीब इज़ देयर हु इज़ रनिंग विद द बॉल ऑन PBA's, you know, task forces, which is, by the way, is not a small feat. Dealing with the bankers is a challenge and a half. Trust me, it's a very difficult job. I'm telling you from my own experience, dealing with the banks and getting them to get the work done voluntarily without any color of money is not easy. So Najib is doing that. Gaya Saab, और उनके साथ नजीब के साथ जो है वो बहुत अच्छा काम कर रहे हैं, आतिफ भी यहाँ मौजूद हैं। सो लेडीज जेंटलमैन, गुड मॉर्निंग एंड वेलकम टू यू ऑल। सो बैंकिंग सेक्टर इन पाकिस्तान इज़ नेविगेटिंग अ कॉशियसली ऑप्टिमिस्टिक अप्रोच बोल्स्टर्ड बाय एक्सपेक्टेड इम्प्रूवमेंट इन इकोनॉमिक ग्रोथ एंड क्रेडिट एपेटाइट ड्यू टू इनविटेबल IMF सपोर्ट एंड एंटिसिपेटेड पॉलिसी रेट कट। द सेक्टर, वेल यहाँ पर मुझे वो मुनीर साहब सामने बैठे हैं तो मेरे जहन में एकदम से कुछ शेर व शायरी भी आ जाती है, वो कहते हैं ना, पविस्ता रहे शजर से उम्मीदें बाहर रख। सो व्हेन रेट कट की बात आई तो मैंने सोचा कि ज़रा थोड़ा सा इसको लाइटर मूड में भी ले लें। द सेक्टर रिकॉर्डेड अ 32% ग्रोथ इन नेट एसेट्स फ्यूल्ड बाय रोबस्ट फाइनेंशियल हेल्थ। हाउएवर, आई मस्ट एडमिट दैट आई एम नॉट हैप्पी एंड इन फैक्ट सम वॉट एम्बेरेस्ड to report that the outstanding SME financing merely grew by 0.4%, even though they represent 40% of Pakistan's GDP. There are multiple reasons for the lack of growth in SME financing, but access to credit seems to be the big one. Banks estimated to lend less than 2% of total SME. I know somebody can dispute that, because the stated number is 4.5 million, but that number is pretty old. That's 2005 or 2009 number. That, in our opinion, that number has gone up substantially up, if not more than doubled. So that's why I think that we are merely servicing 2% of the total SME, highlighting an urgent need for more tailor-made products using technology and employing tools like digital scorecards based on proxy data. And in this context, I just have had a discussion with Farooq on this. Najib, yourselves, and Atif, you, and we will also drag in Nazir and Yaya in this as well. And we will have a meeting with Munir Saab and Farooq to see how we can capitalize on the gold data that they are sitting on in Jazz, and how that can be helped in boosting their financial services side and also helping the entire industry at the same time. The readiness to adopt digital financial services in Pakistan is mixed. Financial literacy and ability to send or receive a text message are the lowest indicators, while basic numeracy and availability of necessary ID are the highest. Gender gaps exist across all indicators, with significant disparity in financial literacy and SIM ownership. Mobile money wallets, however, increased from 9% in 2020 to 19% in 2022, with the urban areas seeing sharper increases from 11% to 26%, especially offering an opportunity for SMEs to take the advantage of this development of embracing digitization. The good news, ladies and gentlemen, is that the digital adoption profoundly enhanced financial inclusion in Pakistan by introducing path-breaking initiatives like State Bank of Pakistan's Asan Mobile Account, or AMA, by providing an interoperable USSD channel and for branchless banking, needing no smartphones or internet. The AMA scheme has onboarded over 5.5 million wallets, 44% of which belongs to women alone. AMA has recently been appreciated by World Economic Forum, which is extremely heartening and encouraging, particularly in the context of the subject of today's conference. Koi bhi hamare bare mein agar international good news aati hai to bada dil bada ho jata hai. To maine guzarish ki thi Hamza se ki agar hum wo it's less than 1 minute ka clip agar wo show kar sake World Economic Forum ka
मेरे पास क्लाइंट आई थी, उसने मुझे पेमेंट देनी थी तो उसके पास कैश नहीं था। उसने कहा आप अपना अकाउंट नंबर दे दो। मैंने कहा नहीं, मैं इतना टाइम नहीं होता कि मैं बैंकों में जाऊं और लंबी लाइनों में खड़ी हूं। तो मैंने कहा नहीं, आप मुझे कैश दे देना। तो उसने कहा नहीं, इसकी आपको ज़रूरत नहीं, अब तो आसान अकाउंट आ गया है। बहुत आसान हो गया अब तो मेरे लिए। पहले मुझे सोचना पड़ता था मैं पोलर बंद करूंगी, घर से बाहर जाऊंगी, अब मुझे ये सब कुछ नहीं करना पड़ता। अब इजीली सारे काम मेरे हो जाते।
जैसा कि हमारी विलेज की औरतों के लिए बैंक का जाना बिल्कुल गैर
Furthermore, SBP's licensing and regulatory framework for digital banks, introduced in 2022, facilitates the establishment of exclusive digital banks like Mashriq, which is representing in this conference today, which are expected to offer tailor-made financial products and services that cater to the unique requirement of various customer segments, including SMEs and individuals in remote areas. वैसे तो हम बैंकर्स जो हैं वो कोई मौका हाथ से जाने नहीं देते शुक्रिया अदा करने का स्टेट बैंक का। तो हम तो हैशटैग चलाने को भी तैयार हैं, शुक्रिया स्टेट बैंक ऑफ पाकिस्तान। बट जेन्युइनली ऑन दिस टू थिंग्स शुक्रिया स्टेट बैंक ऑफ पाकिस्तान एंड सिंस सलीम साहब इज रिप्रेजेंटिंग स्टेट बैंक, शुक्रिया सलीम साहब। ओवरऑल डिजिटल अजम्पशन इज डिसमेंटलिंग बैरियर्स टू फाइनेंशियल इंक्लूजन इन पाकिस्तान। दिस मेटामॉर्फोसिस ब्रिंग्स मोर पीपल इनटू फॉर्मल फाइनेंशियल सिस्टम एंड ड्राइव इकोनॉमिक ग्रोथ पोजेज एन एक्सलेंट अपॉर्चुनिटी फॉर डिजिटल सप्लाई चेन फाइनेंस और DSSF एज यू नो दिस कॉन्फ्रेंस हैज ब्रीफ्ड इट टू स्ट्रीमलाइन एंड एनहांस financial transactions within supply chain offering substantial benefits to SMEs. Recognizing this need and potential, the State Bank of Pakistan in June 2024 mandated banks to develop, implement DSCF solutions within 6 months, emphasizing the need for increase SMEs access to digital and financial payments. Salim sahab, tusi dauda lavati hai na bankaan de waste, but that was much needed really. Thank you very much. Partnership between banks, fintechs and other technology providers can expedite the rollout of DSCF offering, making them accessible to SMEs relatively quickly. And this conference has just come at the right time in this particular context as well. So Monas, your initiative and Hamza's initiative is most appreciated. SME in emerging markets, particularly in Asia and Latin America, face longer cash conversion intervals than those in advanced economies, necessitating substantial working capital demands. Several developed and developing countries have made significant strides in digital supply chain financing through proactive banking initiatives and regulatory frameworks. These initiatives considerably benefited in enhancing Tier 2 and Tier 3 SMEs, which were earlier confined to large corporations and their tier one suppliers. We've seen that in Pakistan too, by the way. As you know, there was a pilot which was launched a few years back at the State Bank also in the sugar industry. But that never permeated down to tier two and tier three. So with these kind of initiatives, that could go down to tier two, tier three as well. A few examples from across the globe. In China, GD.com and Alibaba have provided over $100 billion in financing to SMEs through their digital SCF platforms and reduced financing costs by up to 30%. The Reserve Bank of India introduced the Trade Receivables Discounting System, TREDS, a platform that facilitates financing M and SMEs trade receivables from corporate buyers. Since its initiation in 2017, platforms like TREDS, RXIL, and M1 Exchange have collectively discounted invoices worth over $6 billion in India. In Singapore, Monetary Authority of Singapore, or MAS, has been instrumental in fostering a conducive environment for digital SCF. The Financial Sector Technology and Innovation Scheme introduced by MAS has allocated over Singapore dollar $225 million to support financial innovation, including digital SCF. Yoko in South Africa, launched only in November 2022, provides general working capital lines to over 150,000 merchants, with a significant portion of repayments being automated through electronic sales only. The National Banking Securities Commission in Mexico has facilitated the integration of fintech solution into traditional banking. There was something more to discuss here as well, but this clock is hounding me, so I will skip some part of it and talk about more important aspects. Even in Mexico, over $1 billion working capital financing was extended to SME. The similar thing happened in Germany also. I'm skipping that too. But Pakistan, ladies and gentlemen, stand at a unique crossroads with substantial opportunities and challenges in enhancing digital SCF and SME growth. One of Pakistan's unique strengths is its high smartphone penetration and the widespread use of mobile wallets, which can provide micro loans based on transaction histories and digital invoicing, reducing the dependency on traditional banking infrastructure and expanding financial inclusion which I earlier alluded to when I referred to Farrokh, and we can tie up with our partners like MasterCard and Euromoney. Gaya Saab is also here. See how we can make it more automated. This has been really a revolutionary offering in Kenya by M-Pesa. I am pleased to report to you. अच्छा ये मेरा टाइम खत्म हो गया मगर मैं स्ट्रेच कर रहा हूँ पाँच मिनट और सलीम साहब आपकी इजाज़त से. I am pleased to report to you that under the leadership of Deputy Governor Salimullah Saab, we as the PBA with SBP Power Division and its Energy Efficient Solution Implementing Entity NECA are currently working on introducing end-to-end digital financing solution for replacement of energy efficient fans and at source recovery of loan repayments through electricity bills. This will be a pioneering structure which will be used subsequently for solar panel financing. Nofal is sitting here, he is already working on it, and other much needed energy efficient propositions. The finance minister recently mandated PBA to work with SBP to enhance financial inclusion in agriculture and SME sectors, specifically leveraging technology and existing digital platforms. While there are a number of initiatives to be pursued, 49 in total, by the way, by the SBP steering committee and the three dedicated task forces of priority sectors, that is SME, agriculture, and digital, the top two most impactful initiatives cutting across all three priority sectors are, number one is the development of SME Environment and Performance Index, which was necessitated as the last census of economic establishment was done in 2005, and SMEDA's SME baseline survey was conducted in 2005 by the economic establishment, and SMEDA in 2009 based on sample size of merely 1,300 respondents. The proposed SME index will consider not only the business environment, but also capture actual performance figures of SMEs. This data will then be used to develop a digital scorecard for the entire industry to help tap into funding SMEs primarily operating in informal sector. The setup of similar performance index for agriculture sector will immediately follow this. The second one is the setting up of a private equity fund for investment in fintech startups to develop applications and use cases basically to migrate cash-based transactions to digital ones and help reduce currency in circulation, which currently stands in the north of whopping 8.5 trillion rupees, driving financial inclusion and economic growth. We have the successful examples of Zar Zaraat, Sprint, which, you know, Monas was also a beneficiary of, and Salim Saab patronized it by attending the Singapore FinTech Festival. And Google Cloud Startup Competitions are a reference in this space. This Saturday, there is an event about Google's cloud startup, you know, result announcement as well. To enhance digital supply chain finance and SME growth in Pakistan, a multifaceted approach combining regulatory support, technological adoption, cybersecurity, hygiene, and awareness. And I want to highlight and emphasize on this. Cybersecurity, hygiene, and awareness, and strategic partnerships is absolutely essential. A regulatory push jointly from SBP and SECP, mandating large corporations going beyond the realm of banking and government agencies to participate in digital SCF ecosystem by ensuring their payables are processed through digital platforms like China, where e-commerce giants like Alibaba have created extensive digital ecosystem to support their supply chain. Investment in digital infrastructure is critical. The government in collaboration with private sector through my favorite, the private-public partnership mode, should prioritize expanding internet access and improving digital literacy amongst SMEs. This will ensure that even the smallest businesses can participate in digital economy as seen in the successful models of Singapore and Mexico. Implementing a robust regulatory framework, encouraging and incentivizing innovation while protecting shareholders is crucial while developing innovative SCF solutions. SBP's recent directive vis-a-vis digital SCF solution to be launched within 6 months highlight the urgency and importance of this transformation. Learning from India's success, its goods and services tax network platform, Pakistan could implement a centralized program for invoice registration and tax compliance, facilitating easier access to SCF for SMEs by providing verifiable data on business transactions. The high degree of informal economy activity in Pakistan necessitates innovative approaches to bring unregistered SMEs into the formal financial system. Incentives for formal registration, such as easier access to credit and lower transaction costs, can encourage compliance. We must agitate to the government to consider NADRA as a utility rather than a business entity with the objective of making profits. Unlike as in the case of UPI in India, which only covers its cost for the larger good of digital advocacy and economic prosperity. Collaboration with fintechs and leveraging big data analytics, financial institutions can assess the credit worthiness of SMEs better, particularly in informal businesses, providing a pathway to formalization and growth for the country. Thank you very much for your attention.
ज़फ़र साहब बहुत बहुत शुक्रिया और चूँकि आपने ये उर्दू का सिलसिला शुरू किया है मैंने कहा मैं भी थोड़ा सा कोशिश कर लूँ